If you've ever wanted to set a world record and have $5,000 just lying around, well, I have some good news for you. You can set the record for the fastest circumnavigation of the world, all on regularly scheduled commercial flights. Before you think about jumping on a plane and just flying around the North Pole, technically crossing every line of longitude, there are some basic ground rules. And they're not even my rules. They're the rules of the Fédération Aéronautique Internationale. The FAI sets the rules for all aviation-related records, and according to them, for it to count, you have to fly 22,858.8 miles, the length of the Tropic of Cancer. That's basically the only rule. Start and end in the same place, and you could set this record. The current record holder is David Springett, a former insurance broker from the UK. His route took him from Los Angeles to London to Bahrain to Singapore to Bangkok to Manila to Tokyo to Honolulu and finally back to Los Angeles, all in 44 hours and 6 minutes. But today, that route would take you a lot longer. You see, Springer flew in 1980, arguably the best year to ever set this record. For 27 years, the Concorde shuttled passengers across the Atlantic at more than twice the speed of a regular airline. But in 1980, British Airways tried out a new route from London to Singapore through Bahrain. This route was quickly cancelled after the Malaysian government complained about the noise. In total, this route was only flown 3 times, and David Springett was aboard one. That means he was able to travel this section of the journey, nearly 7,000 miles, in only 8 hours and 40 minutes, instead of the 13 hours this route would take today. So you might be thinking your world record will come with a caveat. World's fastest circumnavigation, non-supersonic. But actually, no. You can demolish even the Concorde's record, because you have an advantage even more powerful than the Concorde. The rise of long-haul flights. Just before noon on March 1st, 2001, a Continental Airlines 777 took off from New York, New Jersey, and flew north. It kept flying north until north became south, eventually touching down at Cheplakok Airport in Hong Kong, 16 hours later, becoming the world's longest commercial flight. At the time, this was a big deal, connecting business travelers between two of the world's commercial hubs. But today, this route doesn't even make the list of the top 20 longest flights. Long-haul flights have grown exponentially, even in just the last few years, and with it, it allows for an even faster world record, using only 3 flights, beating both the current subsonic record at 53 hours and 14 minutes and David Springett's 44 hour and 6 minute record. So, what's the fastest you can fly around the world today? Let's say you start looking the week this video comes out in May of 2021. On Friday, May 28th, you leave Los Angeles International Airport for Paris Charles de Gaulle at 9 p.m, landing 10 hours and 50 minutes later the next day at 4:50 p.m. After a 2-hour layover, you catch a ride on Japan Airlines Flight 46, leaving Paris at 7 p.m. and landing in Tokyo 11 hours and 55 minutes later. Then, 3 hours later, you board your last flight from Tokyo's Haneda International back to your starting destination in Los Angeles. The last leg of the journey takes 9 hours and 50 minutes, and thanks to the international dateline, you actually land 6 hours earlier on the same day. In total, your trip lasted from Friday at 9 p.m. to Sunday at 10:50 a.m., a total of 37 hours and 50 minutes, beating the previous subsonic record by 30%, and even beating Springett's supersonic record by more than 6 hours. In total, these 3 flights would cost you $4,226, a world record, and all you had to do was sit in a chair. But if you need a hand raising the money to beat this record, here's how we can help. Some more specifics about the route are included in the description. The route we came up with takes 37 hours and 50 minutes and meets the 22,858 mile requirement. If you can come up with a faster route on regularly scheduled commercial flights, leave it in the comments below. Whoever comes up with the fastest route will win $50, a nice dent in the $4,000 you'll need to make this journey. And if you don't want to research flights, well, then tell us what you thought of the video instead. And remember, there's always more to learn.